Jesus. Lord, we bless your name. You are so wonderful, you are so great. What a mighty God we serve. Precious Jesus, you are so great, Lord. Lord, we love you. Lord, we bless your name. You are so precious, King. We love you, Lord, and we bless you. Jesus, mighty God, we are here for you this afternoon. We exalt you, Abba Father, for you are great, Lord. Jesus, you are great. There is not a God like you, Papa. There is not a God like you, Abba Father. You are so awesome, Jesus. You are so mighty and precious. Oh my God, how I love you, Jesus. How I bless your name. You are precious, Lord. You are a mighty God. Bakapatanabashi azata. Le abazi apakuza. Kapana zi atali aza. You are precious and you are wonderful, Lord. We welcome you. We welcome you this afternoon. Precious King of Jesus. Precious King Jesus. Precious King, mighty Lord. Precious King, we honor you. We exalt your mighty name, Abba Father. You are great and you are awesome. Shahabakati za'a. Leka padiba. Lord, we love you. Lord, we bless your name. You are precious King. Shabadabasi abana. Reka abashila diza. Da abakita. Sheba azita. Laka padina aza. Father, we love you. Father, we exalt you. You are glorious God. You are never defeated. We love you, Jesus. We bless your name. Sha'aba Aza. Reke Padiza. Di Amali Azaka. Lord, you are greater. Be exalted, mighty God. How we love you, Jesus. How we bless your name. Hamakapati Azaba. Lekati aza tipa aza. You are great, mighty Jesus. You are precious and you are wonderful. We love you, Jesus. We honor you, Abba Father. We magnify your name. Oh God, if it were not for your grace, if it were not for your power, if it were not, Lord, for your love, if it were not for the cross, where will we be, Abba Father? We have every reason to glorify you. We have every reason, dear God, to declare that, Father, you are God and you reign. In your power, in your majesty, you are able, you are precious. Oh, Shaba Adi Ama, Lekete Basapadika, Matiba Azo Rapakada, Heba Shidazi Alaba, Makapazi Abatu, Shikazida Hapa Vi Adaba. You are great God, you are mighty God. We love you, Jesus. We bless your name. Abba Father, Abba Father, Abba Father, Abba Father, you are great and wonderful. How we love you, Jesus. How we magnify your holy name. You are so precious this afternoon. Bakate aba she azita. Likaba hade zapa uza ama. Rika padiza lekaba adravisha. Makapadi aza padoza. Oh Jesus. We declare that, Father, you reign. We declare that, Lord, you are great. You are wonderful and you are marvelous. Mapakaba uza aba. Oh, Father, today we are here that, Lord, we may encounter you. We have come, Father, to experience you. Amakapa la baba baba bashi azata nadaka. Hari kashazi aba leva hadra. We have come to experience you, Father. We have come to experience your dominion. We have come, Lord, to hear from you. We came, oh God, for an encounter with you. Hakadi aba azalepa abra. In your presence, Father, there is power. In your presence, Abba Father, there is transformation. Oh God, that you may transform us this afternoon. Transform our mentality, oh God. That our mind may know you, oh Abba Father. That in our spirit, oh mighty God, we may receive a new revelation of you. Reveal you more to us. Reveal your power. Reveal your grace. Reveal your glory, Abba Father, that we may know you. That we may know you. We desire to know you, Papa. Mapakaba haba tekadika. Resheketi libaza abha mapakosa tiba ala riva hashe adra dikazipa mapakuza hadi ala abha. Oh mighty Father, we have come for a transformation. Transform our mentality. Transform, Lord, our spirit. Transform us. Transform us, oh God. Transform, transform, transform. Your transformation, your transformation. Haba kati aza adahala. Transform our marriages to fit and align with your will. Transform our businesses, oh God. Transform us. Oba sheke daba aba hata likasi aba ota aba. Father, this is not a service like any other normal service. Oh my God, we have come that Lord you may redeem us. You are our redeemer. You are our redeemer. Makapauza ata. You can redeem us today. You can redeem our lives. You can redeem, Lord, my Father, your anointing that is upon our lives. Haketa bauza ata ripa uba asi ada eza. Anything that, Father, we have lost to the enemy, we pray, Father, you redeem us. Raka paiza ada. You are the Lord God of transformation. You are the Lord God of redemption. You are the Lord God of restoration. Restore, restore, restore. Apa kiza aba ala homazi apa ada. Oh my God, we are asking of your transformation. We are asking, Lord, of your restoration. We are asking, Lord, of you. Haba ika ado apa ala. Be part of our day to day. Oh shapade azikamana. Fight our battles, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. Save us, save us, save us, oh God. Leketeli aza ama adika. Habalopa vi adrika zitalaba. Father, without you we will not be here today. Without you our marriages will not be standing. Without you our business would have fallen. But Father, you have sustained us. We have seen you from January of this year. You being faithful, being our provider. Haba kita abalova. You have watched over us. You have watched over our possessions. Oma Oda Kibariva, receive all the glory, Papa. Receive all the glory, Abba Father. You are great. You are great, and everything within you, Lord, everything around you is great. We honor you, Abba Father. We exalt you, O God. You are precious this afternoon. We choose to worship you. We choose to exalt your name. Hamakapa devazi adravaka lepatabada abarika bababa. shele de bazi a rikadi azo apa makapada rikadi azo lapa uva ake anza adra. Let Father your spirit, oh God, move in our lives in a mighty special way in the name of Jesus. Activate, Lord, our gifts, the gift that Father you gave us, oh God, for us to serve you, for us, Lord, to be useful in the ministry. Activate, 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 Father, our gift in the mighty name of Jesus. The gift of speaking in tongues, gift of healing. Makapati ada lukaze ada opa kabaliva hadra. Every gift that Father you have given us in these hands, activate, activate, activate in the mighty name of Jesus, for the use of the kingdom, for the use of the kingdom. Marabababababokapata reketete dipazi apa likapati azapada. Lift a voice unto the Lord, tell him to activate your gift, tell him to activate every spiritual gift that Father God has gifted in your life in the mighty name of Jesus. Gift to interpret dreams, gift of prophecy, gifts of healing, rapa kita, gift of talking in tongues, yeka pa lupa ava, reka papa padi badika, debazika tabali pata. Activate our gift, O God. Activate our gift, O God. The gift that you have given us to profit the kingdom. The gift that you have given us, oh my God, to profit our lives. Activate, activate for your glory and your honor in the mighty name of Jesus. Our desire, Lord, is to serve you. Our desire, Father, is to live for you. Our desire, Abba, Paki, Padaba, Reketeti, Dazi, Abba, Matravi, Alu, Azada, Rekapadu, Abba, Katiza, Ama, Rekepalibadi, Katiza, Androniza, Rikapadi, Abba, Lokabazi, A, Nakapade, Abba, Ruka, Baba, Reketete, Dibazi, Andra, Rikabada, Nikabola, Adikaziba, Rikata nikaduza apa hakade adis reke bada bala bado ida rakapati azi abakuta makapadu apa lekadiza. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, Rila Abu Ashi Ala, Arikadiza Abba, O Adate Kaniha, Nikazo Abba, Atadadiza, Abba Baba Kotolazi Abba, Jesus, 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 Rikatalaba Ova Adi, renew our anointing, my God, renew us, O El Shaddai, Rekapadi Avu Ashila Abra, you have put us, Lord, on earth for us to represent your glory. I pray that, Father, you renew our anointing. Help us, Lord, to live in your will. Help us, Father, to represent your kingdom here on earth. Mapaku aba ala rekapadiva hazra kip. For the dominion you have given upon us, I glorify you, Lord. Use it for your glory. Use it for your glory. Use it for somebody under the sun. In the mighty name of Jesus. Rekepadiva ala ida. Rika tataduza ambravako. Rapadaba likadiza ampalika haketa di ama repadabaza lakati aduza pakate ama sheketi aza le mamadu aza lakavi apravado makade aza rikatadaba aleba azi ata makapaduma riva shida zi ata mela di shadi ama ruva atro Rika bavisha leba ado azi akade ama. Oh mashikazi abaliva as balm of Gilead, O El Shaddai. We need you, O God. We need you, Father, for the next level we trust you for the next level. Oh, Makapadi Abba, we choose to lean on you who is eternal. We choose to lean on you who is without the clock. We choose to lean on you who is not limited. Oh, Pakaba River Adra, you know no boundaries. Makapaliba Adra River, you know no barriers. Rikapaleva Adribajika, you are not limited. You are not a God of limitation. Rika Padiva Adikaza, you know the end before the beginning. In the beginning, Lord, you are. Even before the beginning of time, you existed. Loka Padiva Adivashita, you knew that today we will be here. You knew that, Father, this will happen at this moment. Yoka Padeva Adidakiza, we trust you, Father. We trust you, Lord, with your ministry, with every servant of God that you have lifted in this house. We trust you with them. Use them to attain your will. Use them to touch the globe. Use them to touch nations. Use them to touch cities. Use them to touch counties. Use them, use them, use them for your glory. Maka Padipa Aza Lika Padu Abra Vi Atika. Thank you for the authority you have given us. Lipaka Padu Azapa. Thank you for the healing anointing that is ever present in this house. Thank you for your power that is ever active in this house. Makapadu Alibadika Leti Davasha Dika Mato Mapadivazekete Divazika Labadiva Hadra Latedaza. You are God, you are God. Mekatida Abalova Adra. Oh, Kasheka Diva Adra. Let your power, let your presence, let your anointing. Ama Kiva Diva. Oh, Laba Diva Adra Lekazita. You have worked for us. You have worked upon this altar. You have worked in this house. Maleba Ade Azika. We trust you for the years to come. We trust you for 2022. We trust you. Our Father, we trust you. We may not know, Lord, where we will be, but God, you are omnipotent, you are omnipresent, you are in today and bold in our future. Lord, shine our tomorrow, make our tomorrow shine, make our tomorrow victorious, make our 2022 victorious, make our 2022 glorious. As palm of Gilead, oh my Father, we are ready for more encounters with you. We are ready, Father, for more encounters with you. We desire to hear from you. We desire to encounter you more. We desire you, oh Abba Father. Rika diba loko daza diba hadi kazo rika dibaze diba ado kama de kadiza diba di kale kade anima ado hale kapapa lika te shandari daziha mapa keta lika ze adama raba baba baba loko bukadi andra reke de di masipa adalika diza. You are the Lord of this hour. You are the Lord of this day. You are the Lord of this house. You are the Lord God who never fails. You are the Lord God who is ever present. You are ever on time. We trust you, Father, with our petitions. Oh, my kapa diva adikala. Oh, my shida zikama reva diva. Oh, better our lives, oh God. Better our marriages. Better our businesses. Better our ministries. Makapa ola biza. Rida ba ela kiza. Shakatiza andro liba aba. Mashekete nima ata. Shakalaba hadi. Oh, shatani mahadi kalaba. Oh God, oh God, oh God. Hadi Shamaliba Ava Adro Kaba. You deserve our worship. You deserve our worship. We choose to exalt and magnify you. You are the Lord God. You fail not. Maba Ale Azakida. Oh Rapakashi Adaloka. Oh Lord, you are my God. I will exalt you, O Ever Father. I will praise your holy mighty name. Hoka paida shida liba ada. Rika pasheke diza haba ola. You have done marvelous things, oh my God. Makapadi haba ola rabasha. Reke diza ala raba. Reke teba andro lika shaba. You have been our refuge in time of need. You have been a refuge to those who are poor. You have been a refuge, Lord, to the needy. You have been a refuge, even Lord, to the widows. Makapa ala ida hazahaba. O kapalaba abarekada. Ne shada zi ada lokapa. Rakapapalaba doka zishaniha. Surely, dear God, you are our God. We trust in you. You saved us, O Lord. Needed. You will provide an answer where another an answer is needed. Mikapa uda haba le katiza aba voka diba. Give us an experience this afternoon before your presence, for you are God. You are mighty and you are precious. Be exalted, Abba Father. Makapa lida hazi aba. Oh Jesus, oh Jesus, you are God and you reign in dominion and in power. I exalt your name, Jesus. I thank you for this hour. I thank you, Father. I thank you, Lord, for everybody you have set apart for this service. Lord, my God, may they encounter you in a mighty special way, for you are great and mighty. In the mighty name of Jesus, may they encounter your power. May they encounter, Lord, my Father, your anointing, your visitation. May they hear you today in the name of Jesus. Some, Lord, are looking for hope. Oh, my Papa, encourage them. Provide your hope where needed. In the mighty name of Jesus, may they experience you in a mighty special way. I pray for them, Lord, that are trusting you for healing over this service, oh God. Mekatabi alabatuka. You have made this house a balm of Gilead, a house of healing, a pool of healing and transformation. Mapakuda abariva likaba. Lord, the moment they joined this service, Lord, your healing began working for them. In the name of Jesus, I glorify you. I honor you. I bless you. Some are trusting for their businesses. Lord, I pray for prosperity. I speak prosperity upon their businesses. In the mighty name of Jesus, prosper the works of their hands. In Jesus' mighty name, Hima Kapa Loba Ifahadro. Every door that the devil has opened before them, I shut it down right now in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus, every way the devil has made before them, Rakapa loka dipa hadra, I strike it with darkness now. In the mighty name of Jesus, hola pakiva hadra lipa. Father, make a way for them. Father, open a door for them. Let them see you. Let them see you in their lives, oh God. Make a padiva hadra. Those that are trusting you for a life partner in life. Those that are trusting you for marriages. Father, open right door. Open a right door. Open a right door over their lives. Irakabu habaliva. I refuse confusion. I refuse confusion. I refuse doors of the enemy. I refuse doors of destruction. I refuse doors, makapali adrina, that are not from you in the name of Jesus. Lead them to the right path. Lead them, lead them, lead them, Lord. Lead them to the right partner. Lead them to the right office of work. Lead them to the right ministry. Lead them, lead them, them, lead them. Reka padiba hatanika. Lead them to the right choices. Lead them, Father, lead them. We cannot make it without you. You are the way, the truth, and life. We trust in you, Makaba. Reketina zika. Shaladi kama abaruka. Shalama ebariba hate. Shikazi halabatu nahaba. We trust you, Father. You are the way. You are the way maker. Make a way, my God. Make a way for that breakthrough. Make a way for that healing. Make a way, makapadiha. Lete dizahata. You are God. You are never limited. You are not limited, Papa. You have never been defeated. Rekabadibahano abalika zita. You can do more exceedingly, abundantly, more than we can think or even ask for, O God. Mela bihadiva. Take a place, O God. Take a place and reign. Take a place and deliver. Take a place and heal. Take a place and restore. Take a place. Take a place. You are God. Mapa kapa libahade. Re shazi anta likaba. Reign in your dominion. Reign in your power. Reign, 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 Lord. We came to you because, Father, we knew in you there is hope, in you there is power, in you there is dominion. We have trusted you all this long because, Father, you have never failed us. You have never disappointed. Haba, you are never late. Reka, iba si amalo kabaada. In our yesterday, we have a testimony, you did it. And we know, we trust that even today you can do, you can do it, you can do it. Heba rikalaba shida hoza. Mapakade, oh Jesus. You and you alone are worthy. Worthy of our praises. Worthy of our service. We magnify you, Papa. El Shaddai. Who is like you? You are highly exalted. You are highly exalted. You are full of glory. You are full of power. You are present in this house. Maka padeba halikasha. You are present in our service today. Repa kabahula adahima. Ready to heal. Ready to restore. Ready to deliver. Have your way. Have your way. Have your way. Have your way, remama leba sikania anima kela si alo ama adikana ama mama kozi alade ama ova hina kabaliva leke shida aba si apa. Our parents may have eyes, may have left us, oh God. They may have forsaken us. Our partners may have forsaken us. Our friends, our family may have forsaken us. But Lord, you picked us up. El Shaddai, you picked us up. Yekabaruta nima aze ala. You are faithful, Lord, when our friends were not faithful. You are faithful even in our unfaithfulness. Rekabadima Abba, we thank you. We glorify you, Lord. We appreciate you, Abba Father. Oh Jesus, you are good and you are great. You are mighty. You are everlasting. Oh Rama Shekezita, you are God of this house. You are our God. We trust you, Father. We declare that, Father, you reign. You are so precious and wonderful. Oh Jesus. Oh Jesus. Oh makabaliva hade. Shakaze amadiva. You are so precious and wonderful today. We honor you, Jesus. We bless your name. Repatabadabazi andra. Rikadiza liba ado maha. Thank you, Jesus, for you are great and you are mighty. In the name of Jesus. Oh, thank you, Lord. Ah, thank you, Jesus. I want to welcome all of us to this powerful and mighty mighty, glorious lunch hour service. After this service, your life will never be the same again. Your life will never be the same again. You are coming out of this service transformed. You are coming out of this house empowered. You are coming out of this house renewed. You are coming out of this house empowered. In the name of Jesus, I want us to appreciate the Lord. You can give God a mighty shout. You can celebrate the King of Glory. I want to appreciate all of us, those who are joining online, those who are joining us online all over the world. We welcome you and we appreciate you in the name of Jesus. You will see God. You will see God this afternoon in the precious mighty name of Jesus. I also want to recognize the servant and men and women of God that works day and night to see that this ministry is running. Oh, may God bless you. May God increase and multiply you in the name of Jesus. You can celebrate the servants and ministers of God in the mighty name of Jesus. God keep you and God bless you. I also want to acknowledge our Father, the prophet of this house. Prophet of God, we honor the grace, we honor the anointing. You are a man of God and we thank you for accepting the call of God over your life. We can appreciate the prophet of God in the mighty Jesus. We also have our mom, Pastor Prophet Rosemary, Prophetess Rosemary. We honor you. We respect the anointing upon your life in the name of Jesus. Celebrate our mom in the name of Jesus. Oh, what a wonderful God we serve. The Lord is good. And he is wonderful. Amen. We can have our seats before the presence of God in the name of Jesus. This afternoon I'm saved and I thank God because he has kept and preserved me for such a wonderful moment as this. So I want to believe that as we came today, we came into the house of God expectant. We came to encounter God. So last time I was talking about this this verse. It is Colossians chapter number 2 verse 9. Colossians chapter number 2 verse 9. And the Bible says, for in Christ lives the fullness of God in human body. And I realized as I was meditating and listening from the prophet of God as he was teaching me about God and the beginnings of time, I came to realize that one thing that is that governs the heavens and earth, one thing that governs the earth at most, are the principles that God set to run the earth. There are principles that God set to govern the earth. So he created man. The Bible says in the beginning God created the heavens and the earth. And he proceeded and he spoke donkeys. He spoke everything into existence. But when it came to man, the Bible says he rolled up his sleeves and he went all the way down to the ground. And he molded something. He molded something and he named it man. He said that now this thing is in our own image and should be in our likeness. And there was man. He created man out of mud. And he proceeded to breathe his spirit in this man. And the moment he breathed that spirit in man, that being became a living being. So whatever God deposited in that man, what God breathed in that man was life. He deposited part of him in that man. So the man now became a living soul. The man now was able to move. He was able to be
a man in motion, he could be able to utter words, he could be able to act, because God empowered this man. And remember, God had already told Adam that if you eat from the tree in the middle of the Garden of Eden, you shall surely die. You shall surely die. So this is a man that is being created by God, molded from the mud. And now the God has breathed something into it. Now what God breathed into man, what God breathed into man was his spirit. Because God intended to have a relationship with man. And because now God is a spirit, there's no way God will speak. There's no way God will communicate with the flesh. So he had to put the spirit, his spirit in man. So that whenever he wanted to speak to the man, he will speak to the spirit, so that the spirit of man, he could receive from the spirit, because the spirit was active in man. So now when man sinned and fell short of the presence and the holiness of God, remember God had said, the day that you shall eat from that tree, you shall surely die. So when man ate from the tree, indeed, now sin had entered, and now God and man were not in good terms. And what kept the man moving in the Garden of Eden was him leaning on the Spirit. It was him leaning from him who is eternal. Now because man was used to fellowship with God, man was used to have encounters with God. And because now man has sinned, and the spirit in man, the connection between God and man is dead. Now man could not receive encounters from God anymore. Man could not have fellowships with God anymore, because God departed. God left the man. Because of sin, God left. And he chased them out of the Garden of Eden, which was a meeting point of man and God. So now man began to lean on the ephemeral things. Man became attached to the world, and there is when now sin entered the world. Sin entered the world. And because God is God of mercy, God is a great God who loved man. Every time if you read your Bible, God always intended to save man. God always intended to restore man to himself. So now we come to Jesus. One day Jesus is asking his disciples, whom do people say that I am? And they responded to him and they said, some say you are a great prophet. Some say you are Moses who has come back to life. Some say you are Elijah that has come back to life. But Jesus asked them, whom do you say that I am? And that is my question this afternoon. Whom do you say that the Son of Man is? Whom do you say that Jesus Christ is? I want to read in the book of Isaiah chapter number 9 verse number 6. Thank you, Jesus. Now, this is a prophet of God. Now, the prophet of God is in the spirit and is being carried many years into the future. And this is what he prophesies. This is what he's talking about. He's talking about somebody. He is shocking eyes, giving news of somebody who is to come. In the book of Isaiah, chapter number 9, verse 6, the Bible says, "For unto us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulder, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace." This prophet of God did not only see an ordinary man. He saw more than a young man. He saw more than a son of Mary. He saw more than an ordinary man. He's talking about a wonderful counselor. A wonderful counselor. A wonderful counselor. Now this son, he has been given a child. Oh, Masheka Palabatazi. A child to us has been born. A son has been given. But there is something peculiar. There is something so powerful about this son. He is not an ordinary man because he is coming with government upon his shoulder. He's coming with power. He's coming with authority. And he's saying his name shall be Wonderful Counselor. Wonderful Counselor. If you have a revelation, you'll realize that Wonderful Counselor is the Holy Spirit of God. So this child that has been born is not just a son, a child. This child that has been born is not just an ordinary man. Remember, the Bible says in Christ lives the fullness of God in human form. So for God to be in full, the Bible says that God is a spirit. Therefore, those who worship him must worship him in truth and in spirit. So this Jesus, this child, this son that has been given, he is the Wonderful Counselor. Number two, Mighty God. This Jesus, Mighty God. Oh, Shakama Izatalaba. It doesn't end there. It goes further and it says, Everlasting Father. So this Jesus, the servant of God, Isaiah is telling us that Jesus is the Holy Spirit. Jesus is the Everlasting Father. Jesus is the Mighty God. So in Christ lives the fullness of God in human form. There are people who lived with Jesus for many years. They walked with him. They saw him in action. They heard from him. They learned from him. The book of John. Makapale baazi ara ada sikadama. In the book of John, chapter number 16. I'll begin from number 17. Let me begin from verse number 1. The Bible says, "All this I have told you so that you will not go astray." So that you will not go astray. So it is easily for any man to be misled. He has taught, Jesus taught, so that we may not go astray. So that means that if we have knowledge, if we have understanding, If you can understand that in Christ Jesus lives the fullness of God in human body, that was then. Jesus is no longer on earth. Praise the name of the living God. He is no longer in human body. But now, all this I have told you so that you will not go astray. They will put you out of synagogues. In fact, a time is coming when anyone who kills you will think he is offering a service to God. They will do such. It's a truth that we need to have as a child of God. There is a truth that we need to understand. There is a truth that we need to be built on. There is a truth that has to be revealed in our life as a child of God. Verse 6, the Bible says, now I am going to him who sent me, yet not of you asked me where you are going. Because I have said these things, you are filled with grief. But I tell you the truth, it is for your good that I am going away. Unless I go, the counselor, we have read in Isaiah that he is the wonderful counselor. He is the mighty God. He is the everlasting Father. Now here he's talking about the counselor. He's talking about the counselor. It is for your good that I am going. Unless I go away, the counselor will not come to you. But if I go, I will send him to you. When he comes, he will convict the world of guilt in regard to sin and righteousness and judgment. In regard to sin, because men do not believe in me. In regard to righteousness, because I am going to the Father. Oh my God. When you can see me no longer. And in regard to judgment, because the prince of this world now stands condemned. I have much more to say to you, more than you can now bear. But when he, the Spirit of truth comes, he will guide you into all truth. He will not speak on his own. He will speak only what he hears, and he will tell you what is yet to come. So there is an importance that we receive the Spirit of God. Remember, the Spirit of God is not another personality. When you talk about the Spirit of God, you are talking about God. When you talk about Jesus, you are talking about God. When you are talking about God, you are talking about God. Why? Because now God is a title. God is a title. That is the title that God has. He is God above all. For him to be God, he had to create. He created the heavens and earth to reveal his power, to reveal his dominion, to reveal his glory. He created cancer so that he can reveal his ability for him to heal cancer. He created everything so that he can be revealed. You can never learn about God in any university. It doesn't matter how many piles of books you read. You can never understand God from the books. You need a revelation. That is why when Jesus asked his disciples, whom do you say that the Son of Man is? When Peter answered, the Bible says, Jesus turned to him and he said, flesh and blood did not reveal. So for you to know him, Paul is saying that I may know you in your depth, in your heights. So in as much as Paul walked with him, in as much as Paul served him, he has a desire. He's saying, how I pray that I may know you. He is a man who had countless encounters with Jesus. He is a man who heard from him. He is a man who had countless revelations. But he is still saying, how I desire that I may know you. So God can only choose to reveal himself to us in as much as he chooses to. If you believe that God can heal cancer, that is a revelation. If you reveal that God can bless your life, that is a revelation. If you believe that God can change your life, that is a revelation. So now God is a title. Jesus is saying in the book of John chapter number 4, when he's talking to the Samaritan woman, he is telling her that a time is coming, because God is a spirit. So a time is coming when we shall worship him in heaven. He is the Almighty God. He is the everlasting Father. So he says, that is why I said to the Spirit. That is why I said the Spirit will take from what is mine and make it known to you. Listen, all that belongs to the Father is mine. That is why I said that the Spirit will take from what is mine and make it known to you. In a little while, you will see me no more. And then after a little while, you will see me. Now this rose an attention. This rose the attention of his disciples. And they said in verse 17, some of his disciples said to one another, what in? By saying, I am a little in a little while you will see me more, and then after a little while you will see me, because I am going to the Father. They kept asking, what does he mean by a little while? We don't understand what he is saying. Jesus saw they wanted to ask him about this. So he said to them, are you asking one another what I meant when I said in a little while you will see me no more? And when after a little while you will see me, I tell you the truth, you will weep and mourn. When the world rejoices, you will grieve, but your grief will turn to joy. Verse number 23. In that day, makasheta lazia. Mm. 25. Though I have been speaking figuratively, a time is coming when I will no longer use this kind of language, but will tell you plainly about my Father. In that day you will ask in my name. I am not saying that I will ask the Father on your behalf. No, the Father himself loves, because you have loved me and have believed that I came from God. I am from the Father and enter the world. Now I am leaving the world and going back to the Father. Makapashi Azana. So Jesus is not an ordinary man when he is walking on earth. He is full God, full man. Now, a mystery about Jesus is that he, at all time, he never wanted to reveal himself to his disciples. He never wanted to reveal himself to his disciples. Praise the name of the living God. One day on the same topic, Philip asked. He was talking in chapter 14, verse number 6. The Bible says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. Mark this. No one comes to the Father except through me. He doesn't say no man goes to the Father. But he is saying no man comes to the Father. So remember, Isaiah is saying that he is the everlasting Father. Remember, Isaiah is saying he is the everlasting God. So here he's saying, I am the way, the truth, and life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you really knew me, listen to this. If you really knew me, you would know my Father as well. From now, you do know him and have seen him. The disciples are wondering. You know, Jesus is talking in parables, in mysteries, and he is hiding a lot of information in his words. But I marvel at how close their eyes were. Because listen, he has just talked to them. He's saying, if you really knew me, you would know my Father as well. He goes further and says, from now, you do know him and have seen him. What does he mean? He's telling them that the Father is right here with you. You have seen him. You have been walking with the Father all this long, all these 3 years. You have seen him raise the dead. You have seen him walk on the water. You have seen him at work. Listen, Philip said, Lord, show us the Father, and that will be enough for us. What is the problem with this man? He didn't have the revelation. Jesus has just spoke. He has said, if you knew the Father, then you would have known me. And from now, you have known him. And you have seen him. He chose at that moment to reveal himself to his disciples. Philip missed it. Jesus went further and said, Jesus answered, don't you know me, Philip? Even after I have been among you such a long time, anyone who has seen me has seen the Father. The Father is here on earth. How come he is in heaven? Oh my God. Remember, God is omnipresent. The prophet of God always say, God can choose to become this bottle. He can choose to become this podium. He can choose to become a stone. He can choose to become whatever he wants to be. Now, Jesus is marveled at this, at how blind Philip is. And in our generation, we have many Philips. Jesus has revealed himself. He has revealed his ability to heal cancer. He has revealed how powerful his name is. At the mention of his name, every demon bow. At the mention of his name, miracles. miracle happens. You only need to say Jesus and situation change. You only need to say Jesus and you are healed. You only need to say Jesus and a miracle happens. How come you have no revelation of who this man is? Isaiah saw it many years before he came. He saw it. Listen to what Jesus is telling Philip here. I have been among you such a long time. Anyone who has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, show us the Father? Don't you believe that I am in the Father and the Father is in me? The words I say to you are not just my own. Now, Jesus has just revealed himself. And now, let me tell you something. Heavenly experiences cannot be expressed in the physical. Heavenly experiences can never be expressed in the physical. That is why when Jesus is talking about the kingdom of God, he has been there. He knows how the kingdom is. But because now man is limited, remember, this is not the time when God used to speak to Adam. When God had a relationship with Adam, God revealed his, he had a communion. He had a relationship with Adam. Adam could see visions. Adam could see revelation. Adam could have some heavenly encounters. But because now the relationship between God and man was dead, and man began to lean on the ephemeral things, he related himself with the worldly things. Now his mind is limited by only what he can see. The mind of a human being is limited by only what he can hear, what he can feel, what he can touch, what he can smell. So if I begin to talk about heaven, you may not understand what I'm saying. If I begin to talk about angels, if I begin to talk about the throne of God, if I begin to talk about the 24 elders, the cherubims, your mind cannot get that. Right now, if I speak to you and it enters into your mind, I did it. But if it sinks into your spirit, God did it. So it is unless you have some spiritual encounters is when your spiritual eyes will be open. Remember Jesus, where we were reading chapter 16, he's talking about the Holy Spirit coming and teaching us things that he did not teach, opening our eyes, teaching us of things of heaven, those that are to come. The moment we have the Spirit of God, he opens our spiritual eyes. He activates our spiritual experiences. That is when we can be able to enter into heavenly realm and begin to see things that ordinary eyes cannot see. We begin to hear voices and words that ordinary ears cannot hear. We begin to experience some experiences that cannot be encountered in the physical. So now Jesus is getting deeper. He's saying that now, don't the Father, and that the Father is in me. The words I say to you are not mine. They are not my own. Rather, it is the Father living in me. So those men, when they were hitting this man, if only they knew who they were striking, if only they knew who they were taking to the cross, if only they knew who this man is. In him was the fullness of God. He was God himself on earth.
Makapashiada.
How I pray that we may have a revelation. We may see Jesus as he is. The Bible says in Acts chapter number 4, verse number 11, for there is no salvation in any other. There is no salvation in any other. For there is no any name given under the sun. There is no any name given on earth that man will be saved upon but the name of Jesus. That is why his name is exalted here on earth. That is why his name carries power. That is why his name shakes kingdoms. That is why his name transforms. That is why his name, the name Jesus. Pakate Azala. Oh my God. May God open our spiritual eyes. May God enlighten and sharpen our spirit, that we may have a revelation of who this Jesus is. Father, I bless your name. You are great and awesome. Thank you, Father, for this afternoon. I glorify you, for Lord, you are great. You are mighty and you are glorious. Father, I pray that God, you give us a spiritual experience, that Father, we may encounter and experience you. Lord, that we may know you more. That Father, my God, we may understand you. You are the great God. Jesus, you are the beginning and you are the end. You are the Alpha and you are the Omega. You are the King of Kings. We adore you, Abba Father. We glorify you, dear God. You are precious and wonderful. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray. Somebody say amen. Oh, you can celebrate the Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. I want to welcome the servant of God, Maggie, to come and give us some a few announcements. In the name of Jesus, celebrate the servant of God in the mighty name of Jesus.
Wow, what kind of a word is that? That Jesus came for me and for you. I want to take the few minutes to give us an announcement. We have a service up, a morning glory here from Tuesday to Thursday. And I'm inviting you all for tomorrow prayer session. We have an prayer for the whole lunch hour. So I welcome you wherever you are watching us from. Make an appointment of coming in the house of the Lord, and the Lord will bless you. I kind of want to ask you or request you to send your prayer request online to our page of Facebook or to the numbers that are given in our banner. You will see them. Kindly send your prayer request. We will pray together and the Lord will bless you. I want to give a short testimony about this prayer, what God is doing. God has been saving souls in this place. God has been healing people from this place. It doesn't matter where you are when you are sending your prayer request. I am a witness that we have been praying for people in hospital and they are getting healed. I'm a witness that we have been praying for people who are very far. They said it through online, and we pray right from this altar, and God has been doing wonders. Why not you send your prayer request, you get job, you'll be healed, you get elevated because you have sent and you have connected in the name of Jesus. I want to request all of us that we give our offerings. We come in the house of the Lord, and at every service we have to edit with an offering. Can they give us your offering? If you are giving your tithe, there are envelope around us here. You can give your tithe and the Lord will bless you. And a special announcement on Friday. Wow. Friday we are having a kesha, and this kesha is a wonderful kesha. It's all about transfiguration, and I'm inviting each and every one of us. Whenever you are watching us, we will be online, so you can watch us if you are very far where you cannot make. But even if you can make, you better take a bus and come to Nairobi and have an encounter in this transfiguration kesha. We are inviting you because I know God will do miracle in this place. Someone will get healed, a deaf will hear, a lame will walk, and things will be happening. Our very own Apostle Joel, the father of the house, will be with us, and Reverend Anne, and our own Prophet Kareb Wekesa will be in. Not enough. Our pastors, Mike, Pastor Kimodo, and many more pastors will be available for us. So it is a day. What an end of the year. Come and have an encounter with God. Come and end the year with the Lord, and the Lord will bless you. I want us to dismiss us with a word of prayer as we go back to our working place. Father, in the name of Jesus, we bless you because of this wonderful afternoon. Thank you because of your word that you have released into our hearts, oh God. How I pray that we be the partakers of your word, oh God, and help us to be the doer of your word, Redeemer. We thank you and we honor your name, oh God. Let this work in our hearts and in our minds and in our lives, oh God, because you are faithful and there is no other God like you. Father, I pray for the servant of God that has given your word, Lord. Refill him again in the name of Jesus. And as we go back to our places of work, Lord, we pray that you be fruitful in this afternoon. We will see you, Lord, because you have risen, O God. Thank you because you are faithful, God, and there is no other God like you. We bless you and we give you praise. In Jesus' name we pray and believe. Amen. Can somebody appreciate the Lord as you say hi to your neighbors? You go back to your work. You are blessed. Shalom.